Hello everyone, this is The Hobbyist and today we're talking about the Pipes of Ferdinand Marcos coin. So starting 1975, Ferdinand Marcos created a new set of coins called the Bagong Lipunan. For this specific video, we'll talk about this 5 peso coin from the Ang Bagong Lipunan set. This is being asked for quite a while by some of the members of a lot of groups because these coins are one of those coins that is being hoarded during that time because this was the very first 5 peso that was created as a coin. This is like the current 20 peso which is being hoarded because people like to have the new coin. So from what I heard, this 5 peso coin was being hoarded and was not being used in circulation. Although there are 20 million coins that was minted for the first version, which is the 1975. So for this coin, there are several types that you should look for. The very first one is the circulated one, which is a regular mintage for the 1975 and the 1982. So there are only 2 years for the regular mintage for circulation. For the 1975, it was, as I've said earlier, there are 20 million coins that was minted during that time. So there's a lot of this coin right now. That's the reason why for the 1975, the current price that you could sell this is around 20 pesos to 25 pesos each. Previously, it could sell to up to 50 pesos, but there are more and more people selling this coin. That's the reason why price declines. Again, the prices goes up and down depending on the number of buyers, the number of sellers, and the rarity of the coin, and also the quality. So again, if you have a good coin, you could sell it for 20 to 25 pesos each. But if you have a damaged coin, like there's a hole in it, there's a lot of scratches in it, I don't think that you could sell that one, but there might be some people who would buy that. But for now, what I could say is that is not a collectible coin, so it's really hard to tell how much that is. I could consider that as a scrap coin. You could sell that per kilo, 100 to 200 pesos per kilo. Then for the 1982, the mintage is a little bit lower, though from what I saw on Economista, there's no specific number of mintage in it. But from what I experienced on buying and selling coins, there's fewer 1982 coins. So right now for the 1982, at least you could sell that for 50 to 100 pesos depending on the quality. The next type of this coin are the brilliant uncirculated coin. So from 1975 to 1982, each year they created the brilliant uncirculated coin mostly as a set for the brilliant uncirculated from 1 centavo to 5 pesos. Commonly, it was being sold as a set from 350 to the highest price set that I saw for the brilliant uncirculated one is worth 6,500, the 1977. But there are also people who are selling it as a separate coin. Commonly, it was sold from 100 to 500 pesos each, except for the 1977 and 1982. The 1982, I saw from Abby Reyes, he sold 100 pieces of it and the price is around 400 to 500 pesos each. For the 1977, I haven't seen a lot of people who are selling it. Most of the time, it was being sold as a separate coin, but it's from a tooth set. So I don't have any record of someone selling a 1977 5 peso brilliant uncirculated coin, but I got one from Abby Reyes. And I saw one person selling 1977 brilliant uncirculated. He sold it for 6,500 for the whole set from 1 centavo to 5 pesos. So basically, we could see that the 1977, the 1982 are the hard to find sets on the brilliant uncirculated coin for the Ang Bagong Lipunan set. The only difference from the regular 5 peso and the brilliant uncirculated 5 peso is the brilliant uncirculated 5 peso has a Franklin mint mark. So if you look into here, and I will show you the encircled part is a Franklin mint. So all the Franklin mint coin from the 1 centavo to 5 peso has that specific mint mark. So if you look into your 1975 and 1982 and it doesn't have that mint mark, it means that it is a common circulated coin. which costs from 20 pesos up to 100 pesos if that is a 1982. But if it has a mint mark and it is a brilliant uncirculated version, that would cost from 100 to 500 pesos, except for the 77 and 1982. The third type of this coin are the proof coins. These are also made from Franklin Mint, so it also has a Franklin Mint mark, but the great difference is how it looks like. So basically, if you look into a proof coin of any coin from the Bagong Lipunan set, the proof coin has a mirror-like finish. If you look into it, you could see yourself. So proof coins are really shiny coins. And if you look into the empty space, it really looks like a mirror. That's how you could differentiate a brilliant uncirculated coin versus a proof coin. I don't have a proof coin right now, but I already ordered one for the 1975 from a friend. So hopefully, maybe on the next video, I could present it to you, especially on the difference. But for now, I'll show you a picture of a brilliant uncirculated coin versus a proof 5 peso coin. So for the proof coin, same as a brilliant uncirculated coin, most of the time it is being sold as a set. Most of the time, if you include the silver coins for the Bagong Lipunan set, the lowest price right now is around 6,000. But commonly, the 1975 proof set, including the box and the certificate of authenticity, cost at around 7,500. And the other years are around 8,000, 8,500, while the 1980, 1981, and 1982, I'm seeing them being sold for around 10,000 to 12,000 pesos for the whole set. So for the 5 peso alone, I have seen someone selling it for 500 pesos each, but it's really rare that someone is selling the 5 peso as a single coin for the proof set. Commonly, it's being sold for the set of the 1 centavo to 5 peso. It's really rare to see the proof 5 peso coin being sold separately from the set compared to the brilliant uncirculated one. So it's really hard to say how much the proof coin alone cost. The last version of this coin are the graded coins. If you have seen my previous video about the 1 peso 1972 and 1974, again, there are two main companies who are grading coins, namely the NGC and the PSGS. Most of the time, the price is doubled because commonly, if you send a coin to them, you will pay for around 2,500 pesos for each coin alone. So, graded coins really cost that much. And if you look into eBay, that's why the prices of these coins are really high, because most of them are graded coins. There are people who are telling me that those coins are just encased in a really cool slab. But again, you paid for the grading, you paid for that slab. So there are times that whenever someone is selling those kind of coins, the price is really high. So don't compare your graded coins versus the circulated coins that I have right now. Don't think that you could sell this circulated coin for thousands of pesos. Again, this coin could be sold for only 20 to 25 pesos each. So hope you learned something from this video, and if you like this video, be sure to press the thumbs up button and share it to your friends. And again, if you have any comments, suggestions, recommendations, or any violent reactions about this video, be sure to put that on the comment box below. That's all for now. Thank you, and God bless.